So I run a specialty program for kids who don't eat. And a lot of the children we work with have feeding tubes, which is a tube that either goes through the stomach or down through the nose that helps children meet their nourishment. These children refuse to accept solid food by mouth. And our goal as a treatment program is to help them establish a more appropriate relationship with food and eventually wean from those feeding tubes. So with the app, the idea behind the app is that we bottle up some of the knowledge, the clinician knowledge, our techniques into a all-comprehensive computer program that would allow others to treat children with very severe feeding problems. The goal is for the tool to be able to be used in any clinic or in any home. And so we are looking to get funding to further develop the application so that it can be a tool that can not only be used at Marcus, but can be used throughout the world.
The protocol helps the children get past that feeling of not liking food. The benefit of having the application is that Will can now train multiple people in his protocol, so multiple clinicians can do what really just he himself had been doing before. If you can make it where even one day the parent can take home the app and do it themselves after they meet with Will and get diagnosed and get prescribed the app, then you can imagine that that saves a lot of time and a lot of money. It's really rewarding to see, you know, kids go from screaming, crying, even just a few days later, starting to accept food on a spoon. That's really amazing to see. I think what this says about the relationship between Georgia Tech and Children's is that it's working. We can do things to help them give better care to their patients and make it more readily accessible. I think this type of project works because you have that multidisciplinary team where you have the engineers working with the doctors and clinicians, the scientists, whatever it may be to make the right team. When you have them working together, ideas beyond just what one group would think about really come to life.
Kirsten, he's 4 years old. He has a chromosome abnormality. It's called a translocation. He had a lot of feeding issues at birth, so he had he's had a feeding tube since he was a month old. He graduated from the outpatient program a few weeks ago, and he has been off of his tube for about 6 weeks. But yeah, he's eating 3-4 meals a day. He eats at school. His teacher feeds him at school, and he's doing really well. He seems to be happy with eating too. We've been really successful, and he's doing great. Very exciting for us.